Airbus Cockpit Coach here. You're joining me inside Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024 with the Fenix A320. And today we're going to be looking at a non-position approach using the track FPA function. I've already got the simulator paused and we're going to go into Heraklion's runway 27. Just to recap on the non-position approach, this type of approach, sometimes just called the NPA approach, it's a type of instrument approach procedure that provides lateral guidance but no vertical glide path, unlike an ILS approach. As pilots, we often refer to this as a 2D approach. These approaches can use navigation aids such as the VORs, NDBs, and RNAV to guide the aircraft down to a minimum descent altitude, or MDA. In theory, we could fly this approach today using final app mode, and we've got the vertical deviation scale here on our primary flight display. But there are cases in the real world where we would ignore the vertical deviation scale, and one of the key reasons for that would be that every operator has to issue a list of all the approaches that the flight management guidance computer navigation database is up to date to fly. So we would have to cross-check that if this particular approach wasn't on that list. We would therefore have to deem the information as inaccurate and would have to fly it in track FPA mode as opposed to final app. So obviously in the simulator we don't have an operator giving us that information, so today we're going to ignore our vertical deviation, use final app mode for the approach and look at that technique. Also, if we were planning to use final app mode and we have an accuracy downgrade to low, we would also then revert to track FPA mode, certainly with my operator anyway, as part of our SOPs. To fly this approach, we need one flight management guidance computer to be active, one GPS, two inertial reference systems, one MCDU, one flight director, one primary flight display on the pilot flying side, two navigation displays, and two flight control unit channels, all active. So checks obviously we need to do there beforehand. This will obviously be well briefed as part of our arrival briefing, including the missed approach. So if we ever get any issues with this approach, obviously we want to be well briefed on the go-around procedure. Also, with this approach, we want to go into the progress page, input our airport and runway there. So we've got distance reference, as we don't have DME for the localizer available. We have VORs, but they're not necessarily at the threshold, so distance of threshold is important. Let me just bring up the approach. So, coming into runway 27, so we're currently in Bangkok, so we're going to be coming down to India Romeo 402, 401, and then our final approach fix here, India Romeo 400, we'll be in our 3.4 degree glide path angle down to the airfield, with a minimum descent altitude of 830 feet. Also indicated there. But our go around information here, so essentially we're turning right back out to India Romeo 700, climbing back up to 3000 and coming back round if we need to. What's important here is our distance to runway 27. So we've got 1.9 miles, 2 miles, 3 miles, 4 miles, 5 miles, altitudes at each of those points. We should really have, after the final approach fix, at least 2 points where we can make reference to on our way down. So 2 miles at 860, 3 miles at 1,220 are good points. At 1.9 miles, we should be at our minimums, 830 feet. So the pilot monitoring will be helping us to cross-check this information. That's not something we have in the sim. So we can input this information if we wanted to, as single crew, so it's referenced on our screen. And sometimes we will do this in the real world. So take 2 miles, 860 feet, so 3 miles at 1,220 feet. We could put that in, for example. And how we'd do that is come down to the flight plan page, put in the airport code, Lima Golf, India Romeo, and the runway number 27. Inbound course today to the runway is 270. Now we want the outbound course, so the opposite of that is 090. Forward slash 090, and it was 3 miles. Throw that into the box. insert, and then we have it there. So in zero, so upper place bearing distance 04, and then we have it place bearing distance 04. I just want to put the altitude in now, so right select that, and then 1220 altitude constraint, insert. Yeah, and that's now in there, and it will show up as long as we have constraints displayed, your altitude there in magenta. I'm going to remove it, so we'll do the cross-checking method, so by paper as we come down, but that's there if you want to throw that in. So we want to fly this approach in what's known as an early stabilized approach setup. So we want to be in full landing configuration prior to our final approach fix. That's really important. So we need to intercept our glide path angle and input that 0.3 miles before our final approach fix to allow the aircraft to start adapting to that nose down pitch and intercept this angle correctly. We want to be fully stabilised out here, or even at India Romeo 401, so in full landing configuration. That's really important because the Airbus is quite slippy and you don't want to be descending and decelerating at the same time, otherwise you'll be above profile. Overhead Gonzo now, turning inbound India Romeo 402. It's obviously very important with these approaches to have terrain on your navigation display for good situational awareness. We are ignoring the vertical deviation scale, but worth mentioning that is different to the localizer scale in terms of the altitude it's showing as a deviation. So this is based on an angle. The localizer is based on obviously your position and altitude in reference to the threshold of the airfield. So a vertical deviation scale, if you're under by one dot, is actually a lot lower than you would be if you were one dot under on the localizer. So there's a bit of a gotcha there, so look out for that one. But we're ignoring that today, as we're presuming our flight management computer has not been updated. Maps 1, speed checks, maps 1. Thinking ahead, being stabilised early, we're coming over India Romeo 402. We can now begin descent down to 2,300 feet. .185 knots is the max restriction. Low cloud, I'm not visual with the runway yet. Flaps 2, speed checks, flaps 2. Remember the early stabilised approach criteria. Gear down. Get some lights on. Flaps free, speed checks, flaps free. And we can continue down to 2000 for India Romeo 400. Romeo 401. We're 3 miles from India Romeo 400. around at 0.3 miles, we want to input a flight path angle of minus 3.4 degrees. Flaps full, speed checks, flaps full. There's our configuration. We're stabilised early, which is one of, something we should aim for. Approaching 1 mile out of India Romeo 400, which is our final approach fix. We can obviously make reference to all of these as we go down, so track FPA. Going down. 0.4 is in. So this is where we come to our progress page. Check our distance out. So 5 miles was 1990. Well, you're just about bang on there. Next one would be 3 miles at 1220. Flight directors should now come off. Pilot monitoring will take the flight directors off. Adjusting this by 1 degree gives you a 100 foot increase or decrease in descent or climb rate at the flight path angle. Landing checklist. Cabin is good for landing, go around altitude is set, and eco memo is landing late blue. So 3.4 miles, 3.2, so 1220 at 3 miles. Which is now 1240, so pretty much there. Next one we got is 2 miles at 860. Remember, once we're visual, we can take manual control at any time.
Hundred above.
2890, so a little bit above. My control. Continue. Lights are a little bit out with this approach. Spoilers, desal. And there you have it. That's a non-position approach using the FPA flight path angle mode and runway track. As you can see, there's lots of cross-checking involved with this particular approach. Very important to think ahead. One thing to consider is once you descend below your FCU altitude with track FPA mode, that angle in, the aircraft will continue to descend and there's nothing to stop it. So you can end up in a control flight into terrain event, which obviously you don't want. So that is one risk with the approach. So situational awareness is key. Using automation where you can is very important, to just to allow the pilots you know, the the space to monitor and ensure we're on the right track and at the right altitude. Don't forget the early stabilized approach criteria with this one when using track FPA. That's really important, so you get your speed under control, as excessive speed will cause your approach to be unstable, especially if you're trying to descend and decelerate at the same time. And also be go around minded, so you know, have that well briefed, be prepared to go around with this approach. It does require careful preparation, effective use of automation to give you, you know, the maximum opportunity to enhance your situation and awareness. If you've got any questions on that, please drop them in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.